Mystic Gardens, Diana.
Thank you for coming down.
Thank you for having me. Hi guys, it's Diana with EnjoyYourDreamHome.com and Windermere Stellar. I'm here today with Leslie.
Mystic Gardens.
All right, located on
1954 Northeast 3rd Avenue, Camas.
All right, and this is a wonderful floral shop. You can get arrangements here. Today, Leslie's invited me to learn how to create a planter that hangs all year long, if you want to, or definitely throughout the holiday season. So, Leslie, tell me a little bit about this planter. How do we keep it fresh through the holidays?
Well, just like with any of your plants, it can be in the house, outside, and just take care of it.
Okay, and then we have this vase, and we can put in different flowers, is that right? So we
Correct.
Can change the mood of the
Correct.
Same pot, but different look.
Right, right here we're dealing with a fall thing, so we've got it kind of fall colors in there.
Okay.
When it comes around Christmas time, you can turn it red, and we've got some candy cane carnations over there. Mix those in with some other like green buttons and so forth, so you have to help your Christmas side.
Okay.
But today, yes, we are dealing with the fall and Halloween.
All right, so let's jump in here. So we're going to make a Halloween planter.
Right.
How do we get started? What's the first thing we need to do? I see you've got some decorations.
Right.
The pot.
Right. First of all, I already went ahead and pre-filled the pot with the dirt.
Okay.
And with the soil, you've got to make sure you have the right one, because depending on which type of plant you're using, you want to use the right soil.
Okay.
When you're dealing with succulents, you want to use a cactus one. When you're dealing with the plants that we're using today, we are going to go ahead and use just a normal garden soil.
Okay. Sounds good. All right. And what size planter would you recommend? Does it matter?
It really doesn't matter.
Okay.
I've got these ones here. I've also got some outside that I've started once I've put together out there.
Okay.
And then with this one here, the first thing you really want to start off with after you get the soil in is your main decoration.
Okay.
With this one here, we are actually using a bat.
All right.
And you'll make sure that the on-off switch back here is just about the soil, so you don't have to short it out or stick your fingers in.
Okay. Good idea.
Okay, after you get done with that, you want to kind of figure out which ones are going to be best to put up there. And usually you want to go with the high ones first, just kind of give that ambiance. And since we're not going to bury it at the moment, because we actually want to get our setting set up first, this is how we're going to start.
Okay, I love that. Oh yeah. Okay. Wait, and what are the flowers?
Right. Okay, well the flowers are mums.
Okay.
And then these over here, it's a foliage, but it's also a mood changer.
Okay.
So it actually calms down, so you can have it in the office and stuff like that, just to give it the, easy feeling. Okay, this here is baby tears.
All right. Very pretty.
Can you give it that grassy look?
Yeah. Looks like kind of a hill.
Right. So just make sure that those in there. So now we actually have the start of it.
Okay.
Now, as we do, as you can see, it goes all the way around, but yet nothing is overpowering. You might get the moment because we haven't quite buried them yet.
Yeah.
All right, now after you get done with that, we know where everything else is. We have one last thing to plant in there. And that's going to be the base.
Okay.
When it comes to the bases, you want to make sure that they're just the right height so that you can just bury it to the bulb like we have over here with the one that we already remade. You can't see the base, but that's also where you change the flowers for the seasons on that one. So any of them can be changed around.
Okay. Cool.
So now we got our base, and that's, we're just going to put that right there.
Okay.
But I'm going to leave it out, otherwise we're going to cover up the fountain. So after you have the vase there, that's pretty much about it for this one. That we're going to use, because you don't want to overpower the whole flower. And we're going to just take our little creatures or whatever decoration you want to put in there. And just put them right on in.
Cool. And we got little gravestones and a little graveyard fence.
There we go.
Yep,
just like that. Oh!
Yours will.
There we go.
Alright.
So, I said,
pretty easy.
Go ahead and picture that in there.
Yeah, okay. And then we've got a little ground cover, it seems like, too, right? With these
right.
Pebbles, so you just sprinkle.
Right, this is actually floral glass.
Okay.
And shells.
Okay.
Which is what I usually like to use. They come in many different colors, shapes. shapes, sizes. Yeah, you can match kind of anyway.
Alrighty.
Just kind of sprinkle them in.
Okay.
Maybe any color, but since it was Halloween, we went ahead with the darker colors.
Alright.
And that would be about it. And just to show you how easy it is just to change it between the holidays, we're just going to pop these back out. Now, would you tell me that special little one I have with her?
Oh, yes.
Yes.
There. Okay.
And now we're at Thanksgiving.
It's that easy. Well, we like easy and simple for sure. So wonderful. So you guys, you can see how you can create a festive holiday bowl or a planter without very much work at all, really. It's just
right.
Four plants and your main fountain like this one here to set the mood. And
you don't even have to use a fountain.
Yeah, you could use a bigger figurine or anything.
Right.
Really.
Or even just a bigger vase.
And then swapping out these flowers for different colors, seasonal floral bouquets, which you can find here at Mystic Gardens in Camas with Leslie.
They can also come on down, bring your own plants and stuff, and I can help put this one together, or just give us a call and order one.
Okay.
We can do that too.
Great, and what's a good number to reach you at?
The right number to reach us at is 360-210-4694. And if you do call in, also remember we have the drive-thru you want to pick up.
Okay, oh, I like that. Yeah,
no, yeah, right. A lot of people do.
Okay, well, we hope you guys have enjoyed this short tutorial on how to create a holiday planter. I'm Diana with enjoyyourdreamhomes.com. If you guys have any questions about the Camas area or thinking of selling or moving,
she's the lady to talk to.
Yeah, feel free to reach out anytime. And we hope that you've enjoyed this demonstration and we've inspired you for the holiday season ahead.
Have a great day.
Bye.